How do you feel about T-Hawk?
I think T-Hawk's okay. Since they nerfed his fire, he's
No,
kind of
not
a
like
little
tears, but
worse.
how do you feel about recording him?
Oh, yeah,
Yeah.
T-Hawk's pretty simple.
Yeah, it'll take like 2 seconds, right? All right, ultra double, T-Hawk.
Yes, sir.
Bottom 10 character right here. Ultra double is theoretically okay for T-Hawk. He is a 60% character. His ultra double is weaker than most characters' ultra doubles, but his ultra his, both his ultras are basically a true mix-up with each other. They're both effectively invincible due to their ridiculously fast startup. Yeah, wow, we picked really ugly outfits. But if you're next to T-Hawk and you're on the ground, you're ultra oneable, and if you're next to T-Hawk and you're in the air, you're ultra two-able. So basically, one of them will always work, which means you've got a pretty good mix-up just picking Ultra Double. Unfortunately, that's also true with just SPD and Ultra 2. So you would probably prefer to just pick Ultra 2 and then just either mix up with hard SPD or Ultra 2, because that works in almost the same scenarios. We'll talk about the differences between SPD and Ultra 1, though, because there are a couple that are worth noting. So this is fucking T-Hawk. As a grappler, his mobility is kind of bad. He's got a decent forward dash, but it's better than Gief's anyway. But it is kind of slow, so his level 1 focus is really unsafe. His backdash just doesn't go very far. So his mobility is not terrible for a
His
grappler,
jumps
but
are super floaty.
yeah, he's got super floaty jumps. But he does have jump options, or rather a jump option, and that's better than most characters. So the floaty jump doesn't really work that badly for him. He's also a very okay. Let's just talk T-Hawk. All right. I guess normals, right? Jab goes actually surprisingly really far. Like, I think it's a 4-frame jab, but it goes. You can do really long block strings with jab, like four on everyone, and I think on some characters you can do like five. The crouch jab goes really far as well, and then it doesn't push out very much, so you can use it to tick into SPD. And his light SPD, of course, has really good range since he is a true grappler. I think you can get it off of two really easily.
T-Hawk's kind of big when he's crouching, though.
Yeah, that's true. He's wider than most of the cast. But you can reset into SPD pretty easily, which is nice. His frame advantage on his jabs is really good, and grapplers don't usually have a lot of frame advantage. But T-Hawk's frame advantage is actually okay, especially on his jabs. He can do some pretty neat little links. Like, you can do far jab, far strong on everyone. That's not a super difficult link. Or, like, close jab, close strong. I think that's a 2-frame link. And you can do, I meant close jab, far strong. But you can do close jab, close strong as well. And that's not a super difficult link. And that's actually a hit confirmable link. You can do close jab, close strong, and then cancel the strong into uppercut, and that actually combos. I think I missed it, yeah. But that's really good in a lot of his combos. It's weird that for it's a pretty stiff hit confirm, but it's weird for a grappler to have a hit confirm at all. So in that regard, it's actually pretty useful.
Can you do that from crouch? Like,
No, you won't be close enough, I think. They did increase the range where Far Strong activates, but it's not far enough yet. But Far Strong, or Close Strong activates. Far Strong does go pretty far, and it does go pretty fast, so you can link into it pretty easily. So a lot of T-Hawks do like confirms like that. I actually missed it. But you can just link into Far Strong, which is nice. I seem to be missing it. Maybe you can't link from Far Jab. I thought you could. You can also link into Low Forward, which does okay damage. I think it's actually its highest damage. And then from the low forward, you can actually cancel it. Unfortunately, nothing combos from max range low forward, not even the expire, which is what normally cancels. But you can cancel it into like, I've screwed that up. You can cancel it into light spire. And once again, I'm hitting the wrong button. And if it's canceled to light spire, if you do like
Like a reset.
the light, yeah, you can get a reset into a safely spaced spire. And if you're actually far enough out, you can get a whiffed spire. T-Hawk's kind of wide, so it's going to be hard on him. But you can get a whiffed spire, and if you whiff a spire, you can just SPD. You can land an SPD, which is pretty nice. So that's a nice little pressure tool he has anyway, even though it's not explicitly a combo. It's sometimes good to go for. His far stand short goes pretty far, but it's not as good as his jabs. His jabs, in general, are pretty good just purely because you can. I don't think you can combo his low short into his low jab. I think that's not a chain.
It's a good tick.
It is a good tick. It has. Oh, I got a link. That might be counter hit only.
online all the time. You see people doing this, just take right into SPD.
Yeah, really common. A little quick on the yeah. That's good because of the way this frame advantage works. It's not super frame advantage. It also does cancel, so it's a low that you can just cancel immediately, and that's basically a true mix-up with throw. It's not a true mix-up with throw. The only thing you can combo into is uppercut, which is, of course, massively unsafe. It doesn't combo into spire or anything, I don't think. It doesn't appear to be comboing into spire. I think jab can combo into light spire now because of the frame advantage. But, no, never mind. Still can't. Yeah. Spire is an interesting move. Anyway, you can only cancel into uppercut, but if you're just doing, like, let's say I'm a T-Hawk, okay? And I jump over you, and I do, like, body press. If I do body press, tick 360. That's going to catch you unless you backdash out or you jump out or something like that. And if I do body press low short into uppercut, that's going to...
Yeah, that catches...
That catches the jump. Yeah. So it's basically a mix-up between those two, but they're both massively unsafe. But it's good... The fact that he has a true mix-up is really useful, even though it's massively unsafe. But just for the record, hard SPD does like, I think, 230 damage or something. Yeah, 230. And then the other combo does like 278. If you block, if you get out of those successfully, you can do like 300 to 500 damage to T-Hawk. So like, it's not good for T-Hawk mathematically, but it is good for him, like, probability-wise. Anyway, this is shorts and jabs in a nutshell. It's not a whole lot to say about them. Crouch jab and stand jab, both chains. Important to be able to do combos with those. Just get a lot of damage, catch people trying to jump out. I don't think so. I think usually you use stand jab instead. I'm not certain, though. That looks like it goes farther. Anyway, stand strong is a really good poke. And I said already, but close stand strong has a lot of frame advantage. You can actually... I was doing... yeah, that's a combo. I was doing stand jab, stand strong. But you can actually do stand strong on most of the cast. I thought it worked on everyone as a Vultra, but I guess it still doesn't. Or, like, you have to... They have to be, like, inside you or something. That was counter hit, and I walked it in a little bit between them. That works on a lot of... There we go. It actually... I just have to be absolutely point blank. But you can use that as a hit confirm, yeah. That's exactly...
Yeah, I see that all the time.
Yeah, and you can use a stand strong, stand jab as well, and that still works.
That's like a punish if you don't want to do an SPD, I guess.
Yeah, that's an important combo because you can't combo into an SPD. So let's say I get like a jump in hard kick, I can't just go into SPD because it'll drop. But if I go into like stand strong uppercut, that's an actual hit confirm conversion. So it's important to be able to, or like after a focus attack. Well, after a focus attack, you could SPD. But that's an important conversion to be able to go for. And you can use jab to make it more reliable and also easier. Like more reliable from a distance perspective, more reliable from more frames to hit the combo perspective. So that's good. Stand strong, stand jab, uppercut. Unfortunately, you'll miss the first hit of medium uppercut, I think. And the first hit's kind of important to get because it adds a lot of the damage. Let's see here. Crouch strong, it looks very stupid. It's T-Hawk's strongest action to hit, unless you do a crouching uppercut, it's the strongest action to hit, like, a Tatsu going over his head or something like that. It, for the most part, it's a pretty forgettable normal.
Does it? Does it hit on both sides?
I think it does hit on both sides, but good luck ever actually hitting the back end of it. It does do pretty good damage, and because Crouch Fierce only hits once and then air resets, it won't do as much damage as Low Strong. Because I think it's 50... Oh, actually it does more. Actually it does 90 for the first hit. And Low Strong only does 80 for the entire thing. So maybe Crouch Fierce is better for people tatsuing over your head. Interesting. I wonder if they adjusted the damage of that or whether it's always been like that. This is a really stupid mirror, by the way, if you ever actually find yourself playing T-Hawk versus T-Hawk. It's kind of fun, though. Low forward goes really far. Unfortunately, all the ranges where it goes really far, it's also you can't do anything with it. Like, if you're point blank, you can combo into, like, EX Spire. But if you're far out, the best you can do is get like a tick spire or like a, you know, like a whiff spire into throw and things like that.
If they're holding back, they'll walk out.
Yeah, they'll walk out of it.
You'll probably grab.
If they're holding back, you could just poke again, honestly. You could sweep or something. Anyway, it low profiles, I think. I'm pretty sure it low profiles. I don't actually remember. But it goes pretty far, too, so it's actually a decent poke. T-Hawk is well equipped with pokes. Most of his pokes are okay, and most of his frame advantage is okay, which is once again very abnormal for a grappler. Stand forward is pretty underwhelming. I think it does okay damage. It's like 70. Close forward is actually really useful. It does, I think, the most, 90, and it's only 70 for stand strong. So, like, because it's the strongest cancel, you do, like, combos into it to do a lot of damage to the opponent. And also, it combos into EX Spire. His close strong combos into EX Spire as well, but his light normals won't. So you can do combos like that, and then I didn't have to do EX there. EX can actually get both hits, I think. There you go. You can do actual combos with T-Hawk using close forward and EX Spire. And EX Spire only combos from close forward and close strong. I think you can also do close strong, EX Spire. But once again, this combo is unfortunately very, very picky on T-Hawk. Can't seem to get it. Nice combo. Why is it like that? This is a neat little combo they added. I kind of think it's fun to do.
There you go.
Yeah. Anyway. Let's see here. Stand Fierce, I guess, goes really far. It's very useful in some matchups. It does a ton of damage. What's the amount?
With punish.
Here, let me hit you with it. All right. 120. So it's really strong, and it's really good against some characters who can't crouch it. It's really good against, like, I think, Geef and stuff like that. Have a really hard
Someone
time
throws out
approaching.
Something like this, you can whiff punish.
Yeah, you can whiff punish for days with this normal. And actually, Stand Roundhouse, well, we'll get to it. Crouch Fierce breaks armor. I don't know if it has an explicit purpose. I don't see T-Hawks use it that much. Every now and then I see T-Hawks poke with it. But I think it's mostly just because it's kind of hard to get the first hit.
If they space it wrong.
Yeah, unreliable. I'd rather just do that. That's an answer to focus. That's a funny one. I just messed it up in the time I actually hit. Yeah, you can do that low forward too. It's stupid looking. It's terrible if they actually never mind. That's like a third strike trick. That's like third strike gimmicks. You do that with parries. You cancel variable normal into a command grab. Anyway. Close standing heavy punch and overhead. No, it just looks like an overhead. Close standing heavy punch does pretty high damage, and you can link out of it. I think that all links out of it are. I don't think you can actually combo, like, into a knockdown from it. I don't think there's any way to do that, which is kind of unfortunate. But I think the strongest link you can get out of it is low forward, and it'd be really cool if you could do low forward EX Spire from a close fierce, but I don't think you can. And I think this is a one frame link, and I can't even seem to get it. So. There you go. That's not super useful. It does do 200 damage for both hits, but you'd rather have just an SPD if you're going for a punish. That's the thing about T-Hawk, is like, what should I do? SPD. Done. You don't have to think about things. Stand Roundhouse goes really, really far, and some characters can't crouch it. Most of the cast can. But in particular, it's one of his best normals for catching attempted backdashes are really strong against D-Hawk. Like, it kills his SPD DP mix up. So if you're like, if you get a knockdown on the opponent and you know they're gonna backdash, you can stand roundhouse them, and that does a lot of damage. Yeah, it does a lot of damage, and it's got good full screen presence. And that catches jump out. It catches backdash. It basically catches everything that SPD wouldn't catch. So in that regard, it's like a true mix up with SPD. And it does pretty good damage, and it's safe. A lot of characters can crouch under it and then poke him, and also it's massive focus bait, like, if you just focus as he does Stand Roundhouse. But it is a really good poke, and it does go really far really fast, and it's not super unsafe. I think there are some characters who can reverse it, though, because it is minus frames, it just pushes out a lot. But, like, if you're, if you're like Chun-Li and you have a super, even if you're, like, Ryu and you have a super, even if you're not point-blank, I think you can punish it with reversals. That was not a punish. I just wasn't blocking. Yeah. Close roundhouse knocks over. It's okay. It's not like I think you can combo into medium uppercut now, which you didn't used to be able to do, which is kind of cool. Ooh. You used to have to be able to do EX dive, which is kind of difficult, and also only works point blank, and also is not a super good combo. Most of the time you wouldn't even use close roundhouse, but the fact that it knocks down is pretty good from a footsie perspective. And now that you can combo into medium uppercut pretty easily, that's actually like a decent thing to be able to use, but once again, I don't think it's like super good. But that is nice. I'm not gonna lie. Like, I haven't even thought about that ever since they added medium uppercut second hit. But like, actually, that's really cool that you can just do medium uppercut there now. And I think you can do EX Fire as well. Actually, I'm not sure. No, maybe not. I don't know if EX Fire has struggle potential. Looking like no. Crouch Roundhouse is pretty much the same as Close Roundhouse or Far Roundhouse in that you can catch backdashes and jump outs really, really reliably. Unfortunately, the first hit is 120, but the second hit is only, I think, 50. Yeah. So it's not nearly as good at... Like, if it's catching a backdash, it's catching a backdash with the second hit. Like, let me... Oh, nice punish.
Oh.
let's say I get a knockdown, okay? That's the one that leaves me full screen, isn't it? Damn it. Okay. Let's say I get a knockdown. Like, wake up backdash. Unfortunately, it's the second hit that gets the connect. And that works even, you know, like... It works even cornered. I mean, mid-screen. So it's a really good meaty normal, but it's not very rewarding. But it is basically it's a true mix-up with SPD, and you know, like only sure you can mobile beat both of them, only
can
invincible.
You option select it?
Yeah, it's that works, and that actually gets you the first hit, so that's actually better. I was more showing off that it option selects just inherently, but you can option select it, and I was a little too fast. I'm not sure how fast his jab's a whiff. I'm not used to it. There you go. So that's nice. You can option select with it, and then you'll get the first hit. But the option select, if they're jumping out, it'll get the crouch jab. And if you're not option selecting, you're just doing raw low roundhouse, the first hit of the upper of that will catch their jump out instead of the jab. So it's much better to get the first hit of the roundhouse. But if you're trying to catch a backdash, the option select is superior. And then you can do like option selects like a crouch jab and then crouch jab and roundhouse together. Like that's like a really basic option select for T-Hawk. And that'll get just crouch, jab, and then you can react to the fact that that's working and do little hit confirms and stuff. But if it whiffs, it'll get the roundhouse for the second hit. So that was a little demo of option select. So that's nice. That's a nice little thing that T-Hawk has.
Can he option select? Well, we'll get to that later.
Yeah, all right.
Continue.
That's pretty much it for his ground normals. Wait, hold on. Does he even have a command normal? I know he's got some.
So.
I think he's got some air command normals, but I can't think of any. Yeah, he's got Thrust Peak. I forgot about Thrust Peak. This move is a bit of a joke. So the thing about it is that he doesn't have any 3-frame normals. It's down 4 jab. He doesn't have any 3-frame normals except this one. So in that regard, you can use this to punish attacks that are -3 or better. So it's a really fast punish. But then again, he also has SPD, and SPD is 2 frames. So you can just use that to punish things. So Thrust Peak is unfortunate. It would be kind of cool, but unfortunately, it's completely outclassed by his SPD most of the time. It does have a pretty good hitbox. You can anti-air with it, okay.
Can you cancel it?
Yeah, it does cancel. So you can do like Thrust Peak into uppercut. Unfortunately, the frame data on it is garbage. Like I think it's like -9 on block. For some reason, it just has like a ridiculous amount of recovery. Like Thrust Peak me and then hold up. Oh, sorry. This is a hard reversal to get. Fortunately, because it's a light normal, it recovers super fast. Let me try this. Do Thrust Peak and then hold down back. They might have improved its frame data, actually. I think they were talking about that for a little while. Everyone was like, make Thrust Peak not garbage.
Yeah, that got me.
Thrust Peak, unfortunately, recovers really slowly, which is unfortunate. It really limits its usability, because it would be a pretty good normal. But you can use it to hit, like, Blanca Balls coming in, and, like, you can use Stand Jab to hit Blanca Balls coming in, and Crouch Jab. And unfortunately, that's really important, because T-Hawk has absolutely no ability to punish Blanca. And there are a lot of other matchups like that. You can use it as, like, a poke to hit certain things. And once again, its anti-air hitbox is okay, but then again, you have an uppercut, too, so, like, why wouldn't you just use that? Yeah, but jump in Roundhouse on me. That was a bit too early. All right, I did this a long time ago, and I don't know if they changed the hitbox since then. You have to do it real late. Real late. Honestly, it's not looking that good. It's not looking that good. I would never... It doesn't even do good damage. That's the worst part. It does, like, 50, 40. It does 40 damage. So it's a pretty sad normal. But it is... Okay, this is the thing that it actually does, okay? It's faster than every other normal he has, so if you're going for link combos... It's actually very reliable. So there you go. That's what Thrust Peak does. You can link to it really easily. Honestly, it's a pretty sad normal. It's a pretty sad state, Thrust Peak. Let's talk about his air normals, I guess. His ninja jump normals are all pretty weird and bad. Whoa, I've never even seen that one. It looks okay, though. Ninja jump forward. None of these are really worth noting. You can body splash on neutral jumps, which means you can come down and hit on both sides, which is pretty good against like a Fae or something who's recaing under you. Something like that, I don't know. Bison scissor kicking under you. So he does have a neutral jump cross up, and that's kind of useful. But you can do the elbow true too, but you wouldn't probably do that, but it is there. And I guess the weird sit that he does, the jump around house, and I guess probably the jump forward are probably good air to airs, I don't know. Jump fierce is a good air to air, I can say that for sure. Ninja jump normals, you wouldn't really do that much.
I have to see the hitbox, but that looks alright.
That does look alright. It looks pretty good. Not gonna lie. Forward jump, you've got, actually T-Hawk has a use for almost every jump normal he has, which is quite rare. Jump short, not so much. Maybe like whiff it, maybe, I don't think it crosses up. Even if it does cross up, he has one of the best cross ups in the game in a body splash, so you wouldn't use that probably. Jump forward, looks like it should cross up. It looks like Ken's jump forward, but it doesn't. But it goes really far forward, so that's kind of cool. I think it's the farthest range. Maybe jump roundhouse is the farthest range. That's the general conventional one that most people use. Grapplers have like a nice little mix-up where they can jump from really far out. Like, this is an ideal range for T-Hawk to jump. Let's pretend you're a soccer, okay? And you're like this far out. And I jump, and I do jump roundhouse, okay? If you wanted to anti-air that, and you were Sakura, you would do crouch fierce, right? But if I jumped in and I didn't hit that button, you would just whiff your crouch fierce. I'm that far out that you're relying on my hitbox to go into you. And that's how it is for a lot of characters with anti-air normals. So if you're T-Hawk and you jump from this far away, you can do empty jump 360s and catch people trying to anti-air your jump roundhouse. And that's a mix-up that all the grapplers have. T-Hawk, Hugo and Geef have it on their massive range jump fierces. T-Hawk's jump fierce is not as good as either of them. It's worse than his jump roundhouse, pretty much. It does do 120 damage, but I think his jump roundhouse also does like 120 damage, so yeah, not super notable. Jump strong goes kind of far down. Let's forget about that move. That move, I've never even seen anyone use that. Jump jab is an interesting novelty. It doesn't look super important. It does do quite high damage, and it does air to air really well, but it has one neat little property that most people don't know about it, and that's that it special cancels. Yeah, right?
Can you do that midair?
Yeah, you can. Well, it's not useful if you land it on an airborne opponent, because they're air reset. But the thing is, that's an instant overhead. Like that hits as an overhead, and you can fuzzy guard it. Like, let's say, okay, I'm going to do it like a... You got to block high, then low, right? Block my jump in. See that? And if you're quick about it, you can actually combo that. Like, so he's got... I can't seem to get it. I've had that work. I can't seem to get it working now. Let me try EX. No, it still didn't work.
That's gimmicky as hell.
It's not even really that gimmicky. That's the best part. But you can instant... Let's say I'm afraid of, like, an SPD or something. I can do jump back jab into Hawk Dive. And that's like, not bad. That's actually kind of useful. And the thing about that is that, let's say I get, like, a knockdown, and I go for a body press, okay? And I get, a cross-up. Hold still. I can go for low into combo that knocks down, or I can go into overhead into combo that knocks down. And I can't seem to get this at all. Maybe T-Hawk might have a really low crouching hitbox, for all I can tell. This works on most of the cast.
You might be standing only.
I swear that even with the crouch, this works on a lot of characters. It could be that I'm just hitting it later, deeper, whatever, I don't know. But it's an overhead that combos into knockdown, and it's instant. You can't react to it, and that's a low. And that's a low, the combo into knockdown. So he's basically got a true mix-up that's a lot of people don't even know about. And, we'll get to it. All right, other options midair. You've got the body press, which is amazing. It does pretty good damage, and also it crosses up, and it's one of the deepest cross-ups in the game, and it's quite easy to make very ambiguous. And then, of course, you know, you've got a really good mix-up coming down. As long as you get the frame advantage on the body splash, like I can catch someone trying to jump out with, like, block strings or lows or things like that. Sweep, stand around house, I don't know. Or I can reset to SPD if they're trying to just block. Or I can block predicting an uppercut or something like that. You've got a lot of options, and pretty much one of them is going to work whenever you come down with that body press, because it puts the opponent such long block stun. And it's really difficult to anti-air, because when you get the knockdown, he's like right above you. It's got a really nice hard hitbox to actually connect against. So that's a really good tool he has. The jump down strong is a bit freaky. A lot of people don't really know what it's about. I happen to know because I have the top secret T-Hawk technology. The thing about this move is that it's actually impossible to hit a grounded opponent with. I think there's literally no context in which this can hit a grounded opponent. It has a really high hitbox, and it can air-to-air okay. So a lot of people think, oh, it's just like for an air-to-air. But honestly, other air-to-air normals go farther, so that's not what it's for. The trick is because it has a hitbox, it forces the opponent into proximity block, like hold backwards. You see how you stop to block? It prevents you from moving backwards, but it can't actually connect. So I can use this to jump in and then force you to block instead of moving backwards. It's basically a better version of an empty jump. I can force you to stop moving backwards because you enter the proximity blocking, and then I can come down with an SPD, which I'm for some reason not getting. So that's actual intended purpose. It's a little proximity block move. It's just, it's if you're ever doing empty jump 360, it's like why not just do this instead of empty jump 360? Although it does have a tiny amount of landing recovery, which you do have to adjust for, which I'm not adjusting for, so I'm fucking up my SPDs.
There's a cross-up too. Fake a body splash for that.
Yeah, that's also possible. And once again, that puts the opponent in proximity blocking, which is nice. See, like it stops your ability to move away. Interesting little.
I thought that was its main purpose.
Yeah, that is its main purpose, but it's just
fake,
like
fake a splash for.
Yeah, energy. Yeah, but it's that like it's explicitly its purpose because it creates that proximity block, which is nice. Neat little thing that move does, but I guess it does air to air okay. It does have a very good. It has almost no hurtbox, which means that you can air to air with it decently. I shouldn't say it has almost no hurtbox. You can't like beat jump ins with or beat anti airs with it, but you can beat a lot of air to airs with it, which is nice. Although apparently it's not as good as I thought it was. Or T-Hawk's air normals are good. Something. I don't know. So that's both of T-Hawk's air command normals. And also, there's only one thing left to mention, but it's a special move. So let's just talk about it right now. Go into special moves. Hawk Dive. Sort of T-Hawk's defining feature. The thing about Hawk Dive that's really good is that it's technically a dive kick. So you can do neutral jumps and like just watch for fireballs, and then anytime you see a fireball, it's actually fast enough that if you see a fireball, you can reaction hawk dive, and hit the fireball as a punish, which means that T-Hawk has less problems against fireball characters than like any other grappler, which is pretty cool. And it also gives him a ton of full screen presence. Like, he can just hit you
with a dive kick.
Yeah, hit you from all the way across the screen. And that's pretty useful. And also, any character with anti-air normals usually has a really hard time against T-Hawk. Like, let's say you want to anti-air me. Well, T-Hawk doesn't really have an anti-air normal of particularly good effect. But let's say you wanted. Let's say you were like Cody or something, and you want to anti-air me. Maybe not Cody, because Cody's got like his.
This one kind of works a little.
All right, yeah, let's do that one. Let's say I'm gonna do a jump run house. Okay, you can trade with it pretty easily. Hopefully. All right, yeah. All right, good. But if you were gonna do that, if you're gonna time that with my jump, and then I happen to, like, dive, it would completely change the timing that you had to hit the button. And so basically against any character who has, like, an anti-air normal that they have to use, it creates a jump in 50-50 on what time you're going to anti-air it. Unfortunately, Hawk Dive is pretty unsafe. It depends on the character you're fighting. It depends on the height in which it connects. If you connect it as deep as possible, it's decently safe, and T-Hawk's punishing power is pretty low. But I think T-Hawk can always stand roundhouse it. And I'm pretty sure you can always stand strong it as well. And I'm pretty sure you can usually expire it. So, it's not great. There you go. Yeah, stand roundhouse doing work. But it is a jump in mix up against a lot of the cast. And of course it's not invincible, so it can be beaten. But,
traded with uppercut.
It's a good trade for T-Hawk. It does pretty good damage. Hard uppercut, I think, is what T-Hawk normally uses. It does trade, but the trades are often in T-Hawk's favor, and just the fact that the timing's inconsistent makes it difficult to anti-air reliably. Like, let's say you're trying to anti-air, like, the Hawk Dive, okay? But, like, if I did, like, a normal jump in, I might hit you before you were ready. See what I'm saying there? It's basically a little mix-up jump-in. But, of course, the Hawk type is unsafe, so it's not that good. But that's, like, how grapplers work. It's like you have a surprisingly good mix-up, but one of the options, or perhaps both the options, are really unsafe. So that's sort of just the theme that's going on. There is an EX version. You can do it with three kicks. There's actually a lot of things about... there's actually an interesting... Yeah, if you connect deep enough with a Hawk dive, it won't always bounce off. And if it doesn't bounce off, it's actually safe. And a lot of people aren't ready for that scenario. So a lot of people will just not punish you. You might be able to just get off and...
You can cross up with regular Hawk dive.
Yeah. I was going to mention that, actually. There are setups to cross up with Hawk dive. Like, I think after... On most of the cast, you can do light slash... I mean, light SPD. And then wait a second and then do Hawk dive and get a cross up. I don't know the timing. This might not work on everyone. I don't know. But there are heights that you can get cross up Hawk dives. And they're even more unsafe than the regular ones. But there are ranges where they're quite ambiguous to block. So you can catch some people by surprise. EX Hawk Dive recovers far farther away than the regular one, and also does more damage. It's very difficult to punish. A lot of characters can't punish it. It also does quite good chip. Even the regular one does quite good chip. Tiok, I don't think, has a punish at all. Some characters can punish it, like Ryu can Ultra 1 it, even though it's that far out. It has long recovery, but it recovers really far away. So there are plenty of things that can punish it. It's just... it's a different punish than the regular one. And it actually is Fireball Invincible, which doesn't sound very useful, but T-Hawk has a pretty hard time against Gouken. And if he's charging a Fireball, it doesn't matter what version of Fireball it is, you can get EX Hawk Dive as a punish. Which is pretty nice. A pretty important thing, because Gouken is mean to T-Hawk. And that applies loosely to...
Gouken can just palm it, right?
Yeah, on block, yeah, but if he's charging a Fireball, even if T-Hawk just saw the Fireball, it's still a reliable punish. That works on Jury as well in her up fireballs, but unfortunately her fireballs recover a lot faster, so it's nowhere near as good against her. Let me see here. What else? I guess next special move. So this is an unblockable command grab. It's 2 frames. All versions are 2 frames. It goes very far. Does a retarded amount of damage. Light one goes the farthest, does the least damage, but also leaves you closer. That's actually a really important part of T-Hawk. This is something really important that T-Hawks need to consider. Light one leaves you point blank, and you're ready to push a mix-up immediately. So that's a little ambiguous jump right there. I approached a little bit too much, so it wasn't that ambiguous. Hard leaves you like full screen, and you have to do like a lot of T-Hawks do whiff dive to get closer, which is kind of unsafe. It's not unsafe, but it like doesn't give you that much time to push a mix-up.
Let me see if I can punish it.
You probably won't be able to punish it, but like there you go. You did a delayed standing,
you delayed wake up.
But if it's not punishable, but T-Hawk doesn't have a whole lot of time to push a mix up. But it does keep him close, which is nice. And also it builds meter to whiff because it is a special move. For what it's worth, you can only do Hawk dives on neutral jumps and forward jumps, but you can do EX Hawk dives on back jumps, which is actually really useful. Like in a lot of matchups, let's say I was fighting like a Zangief. And T-Hawk, this is one of the many reasons T-Hawk's actually pretty good against Zangief. If I wasn't expecting an SPD, I could just jump back. And then if I saw the SPD, I could just be like, oh. And reaction Hawk dive. You can do that in a lot of scenarios, actually. You can get, like, jump back and then, like, oh, there's something I can hit. It gives... A lot of people just go into approach mode when they see a back jump. And T-Hawk is one of, like... T-Hawk might be the only character in the game. No. T-Hawk is one of the only characters in the game who still has forward presence on back jumps. Which has a lot of surprise value on some people. What
else is it?
I feel like there's another one, but I can't think of who. Jury used to be able to do dive kicks, but I think she can't anymore, not even EX. I guess Akuma can do jump back fireball, but that's not even, I mean. I feel like one of the
presence from a back jump.
Feel like one of the new characters could. Oh, it's DiCaprio with her spiral arrow. That's it.
Oh yeah.
That's the other one. So that's that. It's kind of good. But anyway, SPD, you do have to consider which version you want to use. For range, the light one is the best. For damage, the hard one's the best. And for positioning, the light one's the best. So you have to consider all of those things when choosing which one to use. The EX one is 5-frame startup, which sounds bad because it's a lot slower than the regular ones. But it's also fully invincible for all 5 of those frames. I think it's throwable, but it's fully hit invincible for all 5 of those frames. And also, by merit of that, if they're doing a safe jump on you, T-Hawk doesn't have a safe jump that I'm aware of. He might have one somewhere, but I have no idea what. But, like, you can anti-safe jump with the XSPD because it's invincible until they land, and then the frame they land, it grabs them. So you can... even if they do empty jump and start holding up, it'll still punish safe jumps. So it's kind of cool that T-Hawk has a reliable response to safe jumps. And it can be used as a reversal just because it's invincible. And regular SPD is fast, but it's not invincible frame one, and it does have one frame of startup, so you can get hit in that one frame. But this one cannot be interrupted, even though it's a little bit slower. Let me see here. What else?
What's the range on the X?
It's about the same as medium. I think it's the same as medium. Yeah. I think it goes slightly farther than light. Or not quite as far as light, but farther than all the other versions. I think it's between medium and light. Medium goes decently far. Or maybe it's Super that's the same range as Medium. I don't remember. I think Super has the same range as Medium, and then EXSPD goes farther than Medium, but less far than Light. I think that's it. So that's that. SPD is really useful just purely because all of the escapes for SPD are super polarizing. Like, if you're next to T-Hawk, you're usually not going to have time or spacing to beat SPD with a throw, and or a normal or anything like that. So, usually you have to hold up, or hold up back, or backdash, or do a reversal. And because you have to do one of those four things, T-Hawk can lock you into doing one of those four things, and then do a very small number of things to counter them. Like, if I know that you're going to do a reversal, jump back, jump up, or, like, a backdash, like, let's say on, like, on a knockdown, I can do sweep to beat jump back and backdash, and then all of a sudden I've got like a true mix-up between that and SPD, and then like your only thing that beats both of them is a uppercut. So T-Hawk can lock you down to a very small number of options by merit of his SPD, and then he can just bait you into doing certain things by merit of that. What else?
He's got like a billion tick setups.
Yeah, you can tick into it really easily. Because his normals have so much frame advantage. And also because the fact that it's two frames, it can punish things that are quote-unquote unpunishable amongst most of the cast. Like, a lot of overheads, for example, are minus two, and usually can't be punished, but then all of a sudden T-Hawk can just grab them. Or, like, Dan's Dan kicks are all minus two, you can just grab those. Or, like... The light one can be plus or minus, depending on how it hits. But medium, hard, and EX are all minus two. So you can shut down.
Pull up all the frame data on my phone. Actually.
I guarantee that Dan kicks are minus two because that's a big part of the matchup. Not bad.
Black light is apparently zero.
It depends on the height it connects.
The rest of them are minus two.
Yeah, light can be higher or lower depending on height. The thing about T-Hawk that's actually kind of important is that he's fucking tall, and that doesn't sound super important. But let's say like Jaguar kicks. Hit him before they hit other characters, and by merit of that, he blocks him, and the block stun resolves earlier than other characters. So some attacks will hit him faster, and because they hit him faster, he can get punishes that aren't normally possible. So T-Hawk's height usually hurts him, but sometimes helps him. Let's see here, and what else? There was like another thing I want to mention. Like a lot of moves are. Like, let's say Decapri's Rapid Daggers. Unless it's EX Rapid Daggers, you basically can't use Rapid Daggers against T-Hawk because even at good spacing, he can usually punish them just by grappling them. Yeah, you can't pinwheel either, actually. That's a good example. Well, all of Jury's pinwheels are actually unsafe against every character. But I think she can space them to be safe against T-Hawk. But this is a two-frame punish that goes quite far, so, you know, speaks for itself. Anyway. Uppercut... actually has, a lot of people don't know this, but Uppercut has the same thing going on that SPD does, where how far it pushes out is dependent on which version you use. So let's say Light leaves you kind of close to the opponent, but Heavy leaves you really far out from the opponent. Or actually, is that still true? I thought that was true. Now I'm beginning to doubt myself. I thought there was a difference, but now they all seem to be leaving it about the same distance, so maybe I'm either out of date or just wrong. The light one does go a lot farther than the heavy one. They have different arcs, but it's very subtle. They appear to all be the same, but the light one goes more out and less up, and the hard one goes more up and less out. So the hard one tends to be better as an anti-air, and the light one tends to be better in combos. Like, if you do stand strong, stand jab, uppercut, that'll work with the light one, But if you do stand strong, stand jab, hard uppercut, it won't necessarily connect, I think. Now that one, that actually works, but it might just be because T-Hawk's wide. Stand strong, and I think stand jab, stand strong into hard uppercut don't work. I think. But once again, T-Hawk might just be really wide. Yeah, T-Hawk's really wide. That won't work on everyone. And definitely stand strong probably won't work on everyone. Oh, why is that combo so picky? So light uppercut is more reliable for combos. And of course, medium uppercut now has a huge niche that I've never had to discuss before because it didn't used to exist until a couple months ago. Yeah, we'll get to that. Well, we'll get to it right now. Medium uppercut can actually be FADC'd. It's two hits. And that's pretty scary because it gives him... It's not... I don't think it's safe. I think it's like... I don't know, actually. I don't know the frame data on it. Reversal... If you have frame data for FADCs, I'd be really surprised.
T-Hawk. It has it for a lot of other characters.
Oh.
No.
Oh well.
Because that's kind of a new thing.
All right, so I want you to try and do reversal light uppercut. I think that's four frames, but I'm not sure. Do reversal jab. Now hold down back, just so you're not moving. That was a punish. So, yeah, it's unsafe. So, there goes that. You can't use it like a free pressure tool. You can use the EX one like a free pressure tool. That's actually safe, which is pretty cool. I'm pretty sure it's safe. Oh, maybe not. Wow, T-Hawk, disappointing me. I thought that was like a thing that you could... Well, I guess you can make both of them safe by backdashing, I guess. So there's something. That's not bad as a mix-up, I guess, because like you know, it doesn't carry the risk of a DP.
They're not expecting it.
Yeah.
I mean, you got to be pretty on the spot with the punish.
It doesn't carry the risk of a DP, but still gives you the reward of a DP. So that's still pretty useful for both of those. Any time that you get close, you can do like if you're expecting like jump out and you want to DP it. I forgot to mention DP is a DP catches. DP doesn't catch backdash, but it can beat other DPs if you space it and time it right. And even though it doesn't have a whole lot of invincibility, it does have a little bit. And then you can EXDP has quite a lot of invincibility. And then you can catch jump with it as well. So it's like a and it beats normals and stuff. Beats throws, I think. At least one of his DPs is invincible to throws, but I don't know which one. Definitely EX is. So he's got options to beat all the things that beat SPD with uppercut as well, which is nice. Oh, nice. I tried to do mine late, but you did yours after reversal, I think. So that's good. Anyway, medium uppercut also, by merit of the fact that it can be FADC'd, can also be red focus cancelled, and that gives you an Ultra 1 setup, or, you know, potentially just like a reset to SPD into pressure. So that ends up doing a lot of damage. And also, it does a lot of, it puts the fear of God into them.
Stun, too.
It does, yeah, it does good dizzy.
Some amount.
Unfortunately, that's a 60%
really
ultra.
If you're close to stun and you get the red focus, you can just do a heavy SPD for the stun.
Yeah.
I guess.
That'll be scaled a lot, though, unfortunately. Alright, what else about uppercuts? I don't know. They have some invincibility, but it might just be upper hitbox invincibility. I don't think it's full body. I don't think any of them have full body invincibility. I know that they lose to virtually all of their uppercut in most scenarios, so you need to really have like good control over when the uppercuts are going to... You have to know when the reversal window is and time it alongside that. EX has a decent amount of full body, I think, but...
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Can
and
you do the EX Condor Spire.
Yeah, I was going to actually mention that. This is actually really important. From one, you can do... It's actually punches instead of kicks because this is older than EX Spire by itself.
Oh, I tried to do
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah.
I tried to do EX
Spire. I don't think it works at all with kicks. You have to use punches. So that's two bars, actually. It looks like one big special move, but it's actually costs two bars to do. On paper, you can add a little bit of extra damage to your EX uppercut. I'm doing it really late.
You gotta mash it, I think.
Yeah, it's kind of surprisingly tight. So on paper, you can use that to add a little bit of extra damage to your EX uppercut, but that's not... That's not why it's good. Here's why it's good, okay? That back for me? You see how unsafe I was? Now check this out. Two bars to make an uppercut safe. Does that sound familiar? So, a lot of characters can't punish that. Unfortunately, you can't cancel into the EX dive unless it connects. and that could be block or hit, but I can't just whiff an EX uppercut and then cancel it into EX dive. So if you can make T-Hawk's uppercut whiff, he doesn't have that as an option. But if it is blocked, you can use that to make it safe. And a lot of people might try and punish it and then realize that it's not punishable. EX uppercut does have quite a lot of juggle potential, which means that you can do... I missed it. This should work on everyone.
Three bar combos.
Yeah, you can
try
do three.
In the corner.
It's easy in the corner. And that's... I don't know why I did what I just did. You can get the uppercut to connect pretty reliably. Maybe only the second hit, I guess. And then you can get the dive after that, if you really want it. You probably shouldn't, unless it's going to kill, because that's, three bars. But it's neat that you can do that. And it does pretty good damage, I guess. That's pretty much all the special moves in a nutshell, I guess, unless there's one I'm forgetting, but I don't think there is. Oh, dude, the main one. Literally the main special move. This is actually not the main one by any sense. T-Hawk is defined by his SPD and loosely by his uppercut, and usually the fact that he has both of them. But Spire is like the move that covers all the bases. Spire is the move that like patches T-Hawk together. Basically, it's... I'm trying to think of a move that's like it. I guess it's like a weird spiral arrow. I don't know, that doesn't do it any justice.
It's just a mobility move.
It's a mobility move. It whiffs really fast, so you can whiff it and then cancel to SPD. I shouldn't say cancel. It tends to beat a lot of pokes. Unfortunately, the frame data is garbage, but if you space it, it'll usually be safe. And it does tend to beat a lot of attacks, and even if it doesn't beat attacks, even if it trades, it does a lot of damage. It does like 120 for all versions. So it's actually a really good move to hit other moves with, and it's also a really good move to whiff, because you can just stop and SPD it. But once again... Once again, the fundamental problem of it is that it's really unsafe, and you have to space it for it to be safe. Like, let's say I'm right here. That was actually not a punish. Do you like a jab? Or do an SPD? Well, that was a punish. There you go. And that's the light one. The light one's the one that's really easy to make safe. The light one is only unsafe at, like, point blank, I think. But the hard one is unsafe, like, all the time. It's only, like, -3, I think. Or -4, point blank, which is kind of nice. It whiffs really fast, too, which is good. It used to whiff even faster, I think. But I think they deemed
it... Yeah, they nerfed it.
They nerfed it, which is a shame, because, like, T-Hawk wasn't strong. You know?
It used to be stupid. You could just spam this thing.
You'd spam it. It would build a lot of meter, too. That's like the best thing. All right, but the regular Spires are actually very forgettable compared to the EX Spire. The EX Spire does everything. No matter how you space the EX Spire, it's safe. It's -2. So, like, grapplers can punish it, but that's it. And if you connect it from far out, it's even safer than that. It actually goes to being plus frames. It goes through fireballs, which T-Hawk doesn't have a hard time with, but... close-range fireballs are kind of difficult to punish, and if you ever catch...
It was just invincible. Is it not invincible?
I think it's the only fireball invincible. Yeah, that's what it's looking like right now. But it goes really far, really fast. You can combo into it, and it does good damage, and it's almost always safe, so it's almost always a good option. It costs a bar, but there's very little risk associated with it. It's like a really good move to just be able to whiff, to just stick out. And if it connects deep, you can get, like, EX uppercuts and stuff. Even if it doesn't connect deep. If it does connect deep... pretty much all the time you can get medium uppercut now, too, which is nice. Really adds on a lot of damage. 60 more damage for that move. That's basically what they did. I was like, oh,
Maybe it goes, like, a third screen.
Yeah, it goes pretty far. It's surprisingly ranged. And once again, you use it for a lot of his punish combos. Like, bread and butter punish combo with T-Hawk would probably be something like this. That does more damage.
Can you do it after?
I don't think so.
No, too slow.
We were trying that earlier. I think it doesn't work. I think it doesn't have juggle potential. It is focus bait, though. EX, I think, breaks armor. Here, focus for me. Yeah. EX breaks armor. Regular spires don't. Yeah. The normal ones are focus bait, but the EX one breaks armor, which is yet another thing that the EX one does that's awesome. So that'll beat the release, that'll beat the backdash, and that'll beat the forward dash. And it beats red focus. Pretty useful. That's fire in a nutshell. It's kind of an awesome move.
You can get it for free pressure on people that, like,
Yeah.
People that don't know what they're doing.
Yeah, and also it catches backdashes. And granted, when it catches backdashes, it doesn't get a knockdown or anything. But it does do pretty good damage. And that will catch people who are trying to jump out or, you know, avoid SPDs. So that's really useful. And it does pretty good chip, too. 30. And T-Hawk's ability to chip the opponent is actually all right. All right, so super, I guess. The difference between super and other SPDs is that it actually starts in one frame instead of two. So there are a lot of one frame moves that people think are safe like against SPDs. Punishes. Yeah, it's like a demon punish. Like Galactic Tornado. Most Rufuses wouldn't do that, but for fear of Ultra One. Like, a lot of overheads are minus one. Like, Yon's overhead is minus one. So you can't punish that with an SPD, but you can punish it with a super. Most Yuns probably wouldn't overhead you as T-Hawk, though. Like, the thing is, it works in a lot of the same scenarios as SPD works, but it works with much higher damage. So that's kind of cool. And it does go pretty far, too. And you can use a lot of his normals to tick into it really easily. Like, let's say I do, like, a cross-up into low forward. Let's just block it. Like, let's say you know that I'm going to do that. I think low forward on block is, like, I don't remember if it's on hit or on block, but one of the ways that you can land low forward, it's neutral. Do you still have the frame data open?
T-Hawk.
Yeah, low forward.
Right. Low forward. Crouching medium kick is one on block, or one on hit. Wait, what? Which one? Oh, on hit and then on block. Okay. On hit, it's plus one. On block, it's minus two.
Wow, that's totally different from what I remember. The point is, any move that's neutral or very slightly minus, you can buffer an SPD after it, or even a super, and the super comes out really fast, and you can
light
catch people.
Light kick is zero.
Standing light kick on hit?
No, crouching light kick on block.
Oh, well, crouch block.
Zero.
Let's say you know what I'm doing. Let's say you know I'm going to go for like that, okay? Like, that's my setup. Boom. Super good for ticking. Really easy to buffer. Even on plus frame normals, all you have to do is just buffer it and then not super immediately, which is not super difficult. Just super on any of his pre-jump frames. And T-Hawk has quite a lot of pre-jump frames, unfortunately. Or fortunately, depending on how you look at it. You can do standing supers. It's as hard as doing standing Ultra 1s. T-Hawk can do it. It's really hard. There are situations where it's kind of useful. But a lot of the scenarios, you can just hide it using buffers. Like, let's say I block an uppercut, okay? It's very difficult to actually get a punish of a super on an uppercut. Because, they're airborne for a lot of the recovery. But you can do stuff like this. They're little tricks. And that was bad. I was a little late. Let me do it with a short.
Should I do, like, light?
It doesn't matter. It shouldn't matter. I fucked it up. What happened? I missed the... I think because you crossed me over. I missed the correct...
I think medium crosses over. No.
All right.
Stays in front.
You can, like, whiff normals and... Wow, T-Hawk. That's freaky. You can whiff normals and buffer in the normals. I'm not very practiced at that, but good grapplers will get good at that. So you can do that. It's really easy against, like a Ryu who does a Shoryuken. You can just whiff a low forward before he lands and then super as he lands. And you can just do all your spinning inside the low forward.
Or you could do, like, you hit a standing move or something, and then you, like, buffer it while you're standing, and while you're walking forward, you're buffering the next circle.
You could do that.
Get, like, a walk forward super.
That works.
I've seen Snake Eyes do stuff like that.
Yeah, I think Snake Eyes can actually do true standing supers. I've never actually seen him do it, but I think I've heard that he can.
I've seen him do, like, standing light kick walk in ultra.
Yeah, you can buffer that. That's really good, though. I'm not very good at it. Not very good at it at all. It gives you a lot of time to buffer if you're kind of... Yeah, stuff like that. I didn't get the walk-in. If you're real good, you can get the walk-in. But you can buffer. You can buffer Ultra really slowly. Ultra works exactly the same way that Super does, except it doesn't cost your Super Bar, and therefore it's better. It is also one frame. I think it does more damage, although I'm not 100% sure.
It's like the most... One of the most damaging ultras.
Yeah, I think it does over 500. Well, hold on. It just said 300, and that's 60%, so logic says that it'll do over 500. Let's see here. You can land it in a lot of the same contexts. It is a one-frame punish, so you can get anything that's minus frames as long as it's in range, which is a surprising number of things. And if you're a good grappler, you're going to learn all the opponent's frame data. All of everyone's frame data. just purely because it'll teach you what you can punish. Yeah, that on that that even on hit is like punishable by 360 or 720s. It's still minus. Let me think here. There's not a lot to say about Ultra One. You can pretty much only land it on focus attack, but there are a lot of scenarios where you can kind of sneak it in. Like here's a classic.
Air resets.
This is the classic, okay? empty jump Ultra One. That works on everyone, like regardless of skill level.
A lot more than you would think. Tiak has really good air normal.
Yeah, and like if you're trying to anti-air like Hawk dives, or if you're afraid to anti-air him because he's going for like a cross up. I did the wrong throw again. If you get like a knockdown with T-Hawk and then all of a sudden like, oh man, nice backdash. It's really easy for him to land it actually. The problem is that it's really unsafe if it ever doesn't land, and he doesn't know that it's gonna hit. He's just kind of hoping that it's going to hit, unless it's a punish, or he gets a focus attack. So it's one of the hardest ultras to confirm. But that's allayed by the fact that it does so much damage, and it's so easy to kind of sneak in. Ultra 2 is an entirely different beast. This one you can confirm in... this one's equally hard to confirm. It works as an anti-air.
From a focus?
Yeah. You have to wait kind of a lot. That was... bad motions. You become airborne for the second part of a focus for Focus Crumple.
What's the motion?
Double half circle back kicks. It used to be punches. I think at the beginning it was double quarter circle or double half circle forward punches. I think they completely changed the motion. I think the motion is nothing similar to what it used to be. I forget though. Or maybe it was kicks at the beginning and then went to punches and back to kicks. I don't remember. That ultra's seen a lot of revisions. They made it kicks because of the command overlap with Ultra Combo Double. It's really easy if you're rolling a certain direction to get Ultra 1 while trying to get an Ultra 2. Or, I don't know. Yeah, I guess. Because you'll be covering double half circle back. It goes surprisingly far and decently far up. It won't catch all cross-ups, but a lot of attacks that don't quite cross-up it'll catch. It has 4-frame startup, which means it can anti-safe jump, I think. Or it can anti-safe jump some safe jumps. It can anti-safe jump 5-frame safe jumps, but not 4-frame safe jumps, I think. So you can get, like, Cody safe jump, but not Ryu's. I think. I'm not 100% sure on that. But it is quite fast. And also, it once again works to catch backdashes and jump aways. Like, let's say you're going to do wake-up backdash, okay? Actually, that didn't work. I'm really surprised. I think I did it too early. There you go. Boom. So, you can use it pretty much to catch all the things that escape SPDs, which is really good. It does less damage than Ultra 1, unfortunately. Considering how hard it is to land, you really wish it would do more damage. But once again, you can land it in all the same scenarios that you can land, damn it, why are my motions so bad? You can land it in all the same, that was too low. Unfortunately, it's really tight to land Ultra Focus, because if you do it immediately, it's easier on some characters than others, too. I think it works on everyone. But if you do it immediately, you'll go right over their heads. Okay, can I get double half circles, please? And if you do it too late, you'll go right over their heads. So you've got to wait until they've kind of fallen, but not fallen that far. The window is really big on T-Hawk, but the window is like 1 or 2 frames on like half the cast, which is kind of annoying. But if you're good with T-Hawk, you'll find it, and you'll be able to get it reliably. Like, I can get it reliably, usually. I haven't done it in a little while, so my motion's kind of sloppy. I'm trying to buffer it. I'm trying to do it way too early. That might be it. Yeah, it's pretty wide for T-Hawk. That would have been too late on some characters. But because T-Hawk's so tall. And it does work as an anti-air. It's kind of long to buffer. That's a problem. I was buffering it too long. There you go. It is actually a genuinely quite reliable anti-air. No, you cannot Ultra 2 after close hard kick. Thank you for asking. A lot of people think to do that. Unfortunately, it has zero combo potential. Like... not even in a free juggle state will it combo. T-Hawk doesn't have a free juggle state. Well, he does, technically. Hold up for me. That didn't work. Try again. Gotta find a good normal for this. That's not one. That's not one either. Come on, T-Hawk. Maybe stand strong. All of these are just hitting you on the ground. Ah, there you go.
There you go.
So that's a free juggle state. And just as a proof of concept, Stand Roundhouse has no juggle potential. Hold on. Well, yeah, okay. Just as a proof of concept, hold up for me. Stamina House has no juggle potential, but it'll juggle there. And just as a proof of concept that has no juggle potential, it won't juggle after Stamina House. But jump again. Won't juggle.
Whoa.
Kind of sad. It just won't work. T-Hawk, or Zangief's Siberian Blizzard is the same way. Even in free juggle states, they will not pick up, which is actually a novelty. There aren't a lot of... There's, like, no attacks like that in this whole game, except those two. So, unfortunately, you just have to actually... The opponent has to be in full... the opponent has to be just jumping or crumbling, or else it cannot pick up. Or backdashing. Backdash... All backdashes are airborne, so you can catch all backdashes with Ultra 2.
I thought the backflip ones weren't... Or was that, like, an old thing?
I think that's an old thing. I think as of AE...
Like Yun Kami.
Yeah, yeah. As of AE, I think... Or definitely AE 2012, but I think as of AE, every single character with... every single character's backdash is airborne. Some backdashes you'll never catch with Ultra 2, sadly. Like, I think you can't catch just Roses, no matter how you time it. Just purely because it goes so far. She'll just get out of range. Yeah, I think Chun-Li as well. What on earth is this costume? Funny question. Alright, let's talk about... That's pretty much his Ultras, in a nutshell. Let's talk about combos. This will be, pretty short. Because T-Hawk's not really a combo character. We would have more
KOG right here.
Yeah. We would have more success talking about mix-ups than combos, but I've already talked about mix-ups for most of the videos, so let's just talk about his hit confirms and shit. That would be one of them. That actually was pretty nice. You can combo into, if you can actually get both, Stand Strongs, which for some reason I can't,
I'm blinking, so I don't know.
Maybe it's just time. Yeah, maybe I'm just doing it late.
You gotta get the rhythm. Yeah, that was it.
Why is it so picky? Against a lot of characters, it's not like this.
This isn't a trial, so it's, like, not too unfamiliar.
That was counter hit.
Counter hit, yeah.
I don't understand.
Pushing out too much.
Okay, that was it. You can do that into Light Spire, and I think that'll be safe-ish. It'll be safe on, like, most of the characters, because it won't get a point blank Light Spire, and Light Spire's safe-ish.
Wait, try it. Do it again.
T-Hawk can SPD it. Guarantee that.
Yeah, that's what it is.
But you can also do... Well, actually, it'll be hitting, so I don't think he can SPD it. Yeah, you can do Uppercut. You can do Light or Medium Uppercut. Medium does more damage, theoretically, but I don't know if it gets both hits on every character. Light Uppercut reliably works on every character, I can say that for certain, but you lose 20 damage. And Medium Uppercut also carries the possibility of Red Focus, which is nice and useful. You can also go into EX Spire. You can use, for Uppercuts, you can use Jabs to make the combo easier. But for EX Spire, you have, and for Alt Spires, you have to use the Double Medium, or you have to use Light Medium. But you can do that kind of combo, and I actually just dropped it, but you can do like, you can do like that, and that works. That's pretty strong. Yeah, my best guess for this costume is a hawk, or something.
What stupid colors is what it is.
Giant chicken. What else in terms of confirms? He's not really a confirming kind of character. I mean, technically you could list like that as a confirm. Like, that's technically a confirm. Like, that's... I mean, it's good to be able to get all the jabs there. Unfortunately, I don't think there's any...
Can you not link uppercut after his jabs?
I think even with the shortest combos, you'll push out of range of uppercut. Actually, that might work. I'm trying to get the thrust peak, which actually seems like it would be okay here. It doesn't seem to work. Even after the shortest combos, it pushes out too far. And I don't think you can link straight into uppercut, sadly. I don't remember the frame data on his uppercuts, unfortunately. I know the light one... I'm pretty sure the light one is faster than the others. And the X one might be the same speed as the light. I'm not sure.
What is it called?
It's Tomahawk Buster, yeah. Tomahawk Buster.
Light is 4, medium is 6, heavy is 8.
Wow. So there's actually quite a lot of speed dissonance. So light's technically the fastest. Light you can actually just link into then. So that's something. Because I'm pretty sure that's a link. Yeah, I just got it. So maybe you could do like, hold on. Ain't that a confirm?
Yeah,
how about that one?
Ken combos.
Ken combos. So that's something that you can technically do. Although, actually...
Pressure on wake up, I guess. If, like, and if they block, you just take into a throw.
That's something. And then you can confirm into low forward as well, I guess.
Which does T-Hawk have reliable frame traps?
I mean, not really. I mean, I guess you can frame trap with stand strong. You can do like stand jab into SPD and stand jab into stand strong is kind of like a little mix up that
catches jump outs probably.
It catches jump outs, but it also catches like I don't know. T-Hawk?
Yeah,
frame traps are weird because frame traps normally work when opponents try to tech throws, but T-Hawk's throws, like, a lot of people don't bother to try. Yeah, a lot of people don't bother to try and tech normal throws against T-Hawk, although it is actually somewhat useful. If you are a T-Hawk, you shouldn't never throw because, one, these throws are super easy to get out with without any startup. Like I know that technically these have two frame startup, but you've got to buffer, you've got to do the 360, and that takes,
and that takes
frames as well. And this is just two buttons, so it's a lot easier to get after, like, the opponent jumps over you. And, like, you know, like, a situation like this, you'll never get an SPD out in time. But also, like, the main reason to use normal throw is, let's say you're going to try and... Yeah, let's say that I'm going to throw you, okay? And you try and jump out, or backdash. If I SPD, and you read it, you get a punish. But if I do a normal throw, I'm safe. So it carries a lot less risk. And considering that people don't try to tech T-Hawk's throws anyway, it's not too bad to just go for, like, normal throws here and there.
Do normal throws don't beat SPD, do they?
They can. It depends on speed. SPDs usually beat throws purely because SPDs work from outside throw range and also come out faster. So, but, like, if you do wake-up reversal SPD and I do, like, throw, meaty, I can actually time my throw to beat your SPD. It's kind of hard, though. I'm trying to catch your one frame of startup. But regular throws can beat SPDs. It's a myth that they don't. I'm gonna have a bit of trouble getting it if I actually try for it. You can also, but you can't. Regular throws can't beat Ultra One or Super though. But SPDs are not throw invincible. I think you can throw T-Hawk out of his uppercuts too. Go ahead and try one of the uppercuts. That one appeared to be safe. I think it's the medium one actually that is throw invincible. Although I'm not sure. That actually worked too. I thought that one of them was throwable, but they all appear to be working pretty well. Oh, there we go. Which
that
one?
Heavy.
All right, let's try light.
Yeah, it has a heavy has like an 8-frame startup. So.
Yeah, that would be the easiest one. But I don't know which ones are throwable and which ones aren't throwable. I think you can throw EX too. I don't remember. Some of them are throwable, but I don't know which ones. If you can throw EX, that's pretty sad. It's hard timing to hit. I think it's so invincible from what I can tell. So, T-Hawk's not free to throws or anything like that. A lot of people don't bother to try and throw T-Hawk, but it does carry a little bit of shock value. A lot of grapplers never properly learn to tech. Like, not until, like, they're pretty good. Or if they play other characters, they properly learn to tech. But, like, you don't need to as a grappler because a lot of people don't threaten that against T-Hawk because just SPDs are so good. That's pretty much all I can think about with T-Hawk. Unfortunately, let's talk about meter really fast. Unfortunately, T-Hawk has very few things that you can use meter on. Like, you wouldn't normally EX SPD because it comes out a lot slower and doesn't do as much damage as hard SPD. You wouldn't normally... EX Spire is really good. Probably all of your meters should go towards that. You can't FADC uppercuts except EX, which costs 3 bars and isn't... I mean, it's good, but it's not... It is 3 bars. But it is pretty good. If you want to devote your meter to that, that's on you. It's not a terrible idea. And same with Red Focus. Pretty much the same exact argument. It's 3 bars, but it's actually pretty good. So if that's what you want your investment to go towards, that's good. That's you. But for the most part, EX Dive is matchup dependent. It's kind of in general useful, but some matchups you just can't do it. EX Uppercut, you usually don't need. EX SPD, you usually don't need. So it's pretty much just EX Spire, EX Spire, EX Spire. That one's good in any matchup. Oh, and that's a pretty good little thing that you can do, is regular Spire into EX Spire. Like a safe regular Spire. Because that can surprise value. That can surprise people. A lot of people won't be just like hitting jab or anything like that. It won't work if they're hitting jab. But it will work if they're like trying to jump out or, you know. Okay, maybe it won't work if they're trying to jump out. It's really safe to whiff. I think if they jump back as you EX Spire, you can actually catch them on their recovery with a uppercut.
Enough you back. If you backdash, it'll definitely catch.
Yeah. But, like, let's say...
Also, what I was going to ask earlier is, can you option select jab Spire?
I mean, theoretically, yes, but I don't know if it'll actually catch the backdash. Whoa. The thing about this is I think you'll just get cancels of Spire into backdash, so I'd have to do... I mean, of jab into Spire. So I think I'd have to do low short, actually.
Well, it's like Yun's dash, kind of. The dash punch option select.
Did that punish? That one only works by merit of chaining, and this one... Actually, you know what? That might work. I don't know if that'll work, because I think if I do it super fast, it'll just cancel into the Spire. I'll do it with low short, though. Fuck. Did that punish?
Try it one more time.
That was way too slow.
Oh, well.
That was an accident. Damn it. My option selects are kind of ugly. I usually option select at the normals. That's too slow. Sad.
I think it would have worked before they nerfed it.
Maybe. You got sweep anyway in Stamina House, and you can option select both of those, so, you know, not terrible. That's not a bad option select. Like, check it out. There, easy option select.
What about jump outs, like neutral jump? Does it work on that?
Oh, you do it slow so it doesn't cancel. But yeah, that doesn't work then, because...
they'd probably get a punish if you did that.
Yeah, it comes out too slow to catch...
Oh, yeah.
Oh, but hold on. Sorry, I was answering a guy in the chat. Neutral jumps? Hold on, let me try it. Do a backdash.
Yeah, I think I'll just get hit.
The option select won't... I thought you meant you were going to... It'll catch the backdash, and it won't catch the short. The initial short will catch the jump out, so I won't even get the stamina house if I do it right. So that's that. That's Tiak has an okay option selecting game, unfortunately. I shouldn't say unfortunately. It's not... Unfortunately, he can't get Spire. I don't know if I have that much else to say about T-Hawk. Anti-air's uppercut. Mix-up is uppercut versus SVD versus sweep versus block versus, you know, whatever. Spire. Stamron House. He can win purely in footsies by poking with his various good normals. Good frame advantage. Etc. Yeah. That's about it. He's a poking character, and also he has a 360.
About, like, how do you beat low forwards from Shadows?
I don't know.
What's
EX Spire. Regular Spire. Any Spire. It goes over lows. Unfortunately, you have to kind of pick a far version to safely actually travel over them. Probably EX. EX would be the best one. But it will go over the low and punish the opponent. So that's good.
There you go.
Okay. That's T-Hawk. Thanks.